In this video, I'm going to talk about passive range of motion of the knee joint. Hi and welcome back to PhysioTutors. As we have already discussed the objectives of testing passive range of motion in our video on the hip joint, we will skip this step and directly move on to the assessment. Keep in mind though that you always start with the unaffected limb before you move on to the affected one. For passive range of motion in the knee joint, we are looking at the following movements: flexion and extension, internal and external rotation of the tibia on the femur, as well as medial, lateral, and inferior and superior glides of the patella. For flexion, have your patient in supine position. Then grab onto the leg above the ankle. You may also use your other hand to palpate the joint line. And then bring the foot as far as possible to the buttocks. The normal end feel for flexion is tissue approximation. To assess extension, fixate the femur above the patella with one hand, and then grab onto the leg above the ankle and perform passive extension. The normal end feel for extension is tissue stretch. To assess patella mobility, have your patient in supine position with a fully extended leg. Then we can perform medial glides, lateral glides, superior glides, and inferior glides. For the inferior glide, you have this hand placement as a possibility, or use your PZ form. Passively assess internal and external rotation of the tibia on the femur, have your patient in supine lying position and bring the knee joint into the maximally loose packed position, which is 25 degrees of knee flexion. You can achieve this position by placing a cushion underneath the knee joint, or you can hold the femur in your one hand, grab onto the tibia above the ankle joint with your other hand, bring the knee into 25 degrees of knee flexion, and then perform lateral rotation and medial rotation. For both of these movements, the end feel is tissue stretch. Okay, this was our video on passive range of motion of the knee joint. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to leave a thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe to our channel if you haven't. And also make sure to check out the video on active range of motion of the knee joint, as well as on how to test resisted isometric testing by clicking on the videos on my right. This was Andreas for PhysioTutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.